Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar with another unboxing and review in product review. iPad was the first commercially viable tablet to be introduced by Steve Jobs at a time when such devices were at the lowest in terms of functionality and productivity. Many felt that it was perhaps just another fancy stuff, but when it was launched, people couldn't get enough of it. It was the first tablet to make use of a software that seamlessly integrated touch inputs. Unlike the Microsoft tablet PCs which use Windows XP to be used with pen inputs, the iPad used the same concept of iPhones but in a bigger scale. From 2010 to 2018, iPads have come a long way. Apple has been constantly reinventing its iPads since its launch and is probably the only company that is actually trying to make tablets replace laptops. The Pro series was launched in 2016. In that year, guess how many companies came within a million miles of matching the speed, power, convenience, and app selection of the old iPad Pro? Can you guess? The answer is zero. No, don't think about Samsung Galaxy S3 or Microsoft Surface Pro 4 series. Firstly, the Samsung tablet with its unoptimized OS and a plastic pen are absolutely no match for the iPad Pro. Though Samsung has been including its stylus for quite a while, but the look and feel of the stylus was so bad that not even 1% of the people who buy Samsung devices actively use the stylus. Moreover, the Surface Pro 4 is actually a laptop with just the look of a tablet. The OS is not meant for finger input. Try navigating through a web browser in Surface Pro 4 and you'll be craving for a mouse immediately. This video is about the unboxing and review of iPad Pro 10.5 inch. I had bought two iPad Pros 12.9 inch earlier this year for my wife and daughter and was actually waiting for the 2018 edition, which is yet to be unveiled, perhaps in September 2018. I need two iPads, one for reading books, writing points in a meeting, using as a teleprompter, and the other for using in my classes as a whiteboard device for writing, for which I would prefer to have a 12.9 inch. So this is the 10.5 that I bought a couple of days back. The 10.5 inch iPad Pro represents Apple deciding to make a tablet with absolutely everything crammed in. The best in audio performance, the cream of the company's mobile screen tech, and all the power that can be crammed inside the metal walls of a digital slate. So here is the unboxing. Let's unbox the device. I'm cutting the tape first. It is simple. Just lift the lid and you see the device. I've got the space gray color. I'm not a big fan of colors as I'm going to put this in a case, so anyway the colors are not going to be visible. Lifting the device without nails is a tad difficult, so I'm using the knife to help me. Extremely lightweight compared to my previous iPad, which is the third generation iPad, and at the same time bigger display. Now let's look at the accessories. Lightning charging cable, user manual and warranty, and a 12 watt charging adapter. So what's in the box? The box contains the iPad Pro, lightning cable, USB 12 watt adapter. There is no earphone or Apple Pencil, just some paperwork. And now comes the specs. Most of the features of the new iPad Pro models, both 10.5 and 12.9 inch, are the same. So the only point of difference is the size of the screen. So let's first talk about the display. The display size is a gorgeous 10.5 inch diagonal LED backlit multi-touch display. It has a 2224x1668 resolution at 264 pixels per inch, while the 12.9 has a 2732x2048 pixel with the same PPI, and the Retina display was redesigned to include a new feature called ProMotion. And this is a feature that you need to see and which I could probably not replicate in my video. ProMotion automatically adjusts the refresh rate to the movement of the content. The refresh rate can go as high as up to 120 Hz. For instance, when you are drawing with Apple Pencil, and goes down when you are reading an ebook, thanks to which the power consumption can be considerably reduced. And this is not easily seen in a video because it refreshes 120 times a second when I'm writing or when I'm scrolling. And whereas my camera is only recording it in 30 frames a second. So I will never be able to show you that. It is an experience that you need to see. And the best way to experience that, go to an Apple store, go for an iPad Air, look at an iPad Air and the iPad Pro together and try scrolling them fast, and you'll be able to see what ProMotion does. You will be able to see every letter, every icon as fluid, as clearly as you would do on a stationary screen, even when the screen is moving fast. That is ProMotion. Next is processor. iPad Pro has the A10X Fusion chip with 64-bit architecture and embedded M10 co-processor. The one that I have has 256 GB of storage and 4 GB of RAM and is Wi-Fi only model. The variations that you get are 64 GB, 256 GB and 512 GB. There is no sweet spot of 128 GB available now. All variations come with Wi-Fi only as well as cellular models. The Geekbench scores are astounding. The iPad Pro seems to beat many laptops and ultrabooks hands down. Let's look at the physical connectors. It has the Lightning connector port at the bottom, Smart connector for Apple wireless keyboards for iPad on the left side, a 3.5 mm jack at top left, the on-off on the top right, dual microphones at top and back, volume control button on top right, and if you have a cellular device, then a SIM tray at bottom right. Now, the dimensions. The 10.5 inch model is 9.8 inch in length, 6.8 inch in width, and about 0.24 inch in thickness. And the Wi-Fi only model weighs about 469 gram. Next is an amazing feature, which is the sound. It's got quad speakers, two on each side. The sound quality is crisp, clear, with all frequencies nicely balanced without too much of bass. The sound quality and volume coming from the tablet is sensational. Nobody who's heard it has been anything other than impressed. That's due to the large chambers which allow the audio from the speakers to reverberate for a deeper, richer sound. And I want you to experience this. So here is a recording. So that was the sound. Next is aspect ratio. Now the important thing to note is that the iPad Pro, just like the previous iPads, has a 4:3 aspect ratio, which is ideal for reading books, Writing notes? Well, all the HD movies are generally in 16:9 ratio. So you will be seeing black bars on the top and bottom of the video, and sometimes even on the sides. Also, if you mirror the display on an HD or a 4K TV, the iPad Pro display will not occupy the entire TV screen, as the TV screen generally is 16:9. Some TVs have the option of stretching the display to fill the screen, though I will never suggest you do that. Now let's look at the camera. A feature which is great but is a cringe-worthy topic, the camera on a tablet. Though I'm offended when somebody holds a giant tablet to take a snap, I find it extremely pleasing to see someone making use of the scanner apps to take shots of some handwritten pages, which is one of the best uses of iPad cameras. Skype or FaceTime cannot be the real judge of camera, as they depend majorly on the internet connection speed. I'm also annoyed that Apple decided to make the camera sensor so competent on the new iPad Pro, as it means some people will be encouraged to take pictures with it. There's a 12 megapixel sensor with optical image stabilization on the back, with an aperture of f1.8. The front facing sensor is 7 megapixel and comes with the same power as the iPhone 7. Just be careful when taking a photo with the flash on, as the screen is so big that it's rather blinding from the front-facing camera. The front-facing camera, which is arguably the more important of the sensors, is very good too, capturing natural-looking pictures even in darker conditions. It also comes with live photos functionality and the ability to take a square picture should you be desperate to make Instagrammable snaps from the front of an iPad. However, using the camera with the other apps shows it is worth having a powerful sensor in the camera on the iPad Pro, as scanned images and text are much sharper thanks to the improved brightness and clarity on offer. Video recording is also at an all-time high. 4K video at 30fps, 1080 at 30 and 60fps, 720 at 30 and 60, slow motion at 1080p at 120fps, and at 720p up to 240fps is mind-boggling. It has quad LED True Tone flash, in which the color of the flash depends on the surrounding light. You can capture time-lapse video with optical image stabilization and host of other features. Next is battery life. The battery life on the 10.5 inch iPad Pro is, well, rather dependent on what you actually do with it. If you're just going to leave it in a bag for days on end, pulling it out for a spot of word processing or the odd movie, you'll easily get a week's worth of standby from a single charge. So conversely, if you are getting a week's charge, then you should not have bought this device. For the beast that it is, you should have bought the iPad 2018 or the iPad Air. This device is for people who have a lot of pencil work to be done, like teachers, students, and graphic professionals. For students, of course, the 2018 iPad would be a better bargain in terms of price, but for other serious professionals who wish to use the tablet that is light yet powerful for graphic design, this is the best bet. And I've known people, and I know people, who have converted their work, professional artists, converted their work from the Wacom Cintiq line to the iPad Pro. The 10.5 inch model has 8134 milliamp battery, which according to Apple lasts for 10 hours of continuous video playback. But in my testing, I could get around 8 to 8.5 hours of regular writing time, including YouTube videos and surfing the web. If you're using the new iPad Pro as a word processing machine, I found that the battery depleted by around 12 to 13% per hour, with the screen turned up to the highest brightness, which makes for a more comfortable working environment. Watching a full HD movie drops the battery percentage by around 18% per hour. Both models allow for faster charging using the Lightning to USB-C adapter and connecting the Type-C to a power adapter around 29 watts or more. Now the most important accessory, the Apple Pencil. For me, the Apple Pencil is perhaps the most important accessory of this iPad. The pencil costed me around ₹8,600, close to $120. It comes with a lightning charging cable, a lightning female to female adapter, and an extra nib. The Apple Pencil is a stylus that's targeted at artists, teachers, students, and designers. I use it with note-taking apps like Notability, Note Plus, and the native Notes app. I found it to be pretty good for doodling in all the apps, and the iPad's palm rejection was exceptional. When I used the pencil, the iPad Pro didn't register my hands touching the screen at all. I used the pencil to take notes while watching videos, and it was a splendid pen and paper replacement for that purpose. Though the iPad doesn't have any pencil holder of its own, but there are several iPad sleeves which have pencil holders that make losing the pencil not that easy. In my opinion, if you want to use the iPad for writing, I would suggest the following accessories while buying the iPad. First is a screen protector, and make sure you get it put in the store itself if you're buying it offline. And if you buy it online, go to a store to get it put by professionals. Many screen protectors have been wasted by people trying to put them themselves. Moreover, make sure the screen protector is not a simple lamination but a tempered glass. Secondly, buy the Apple Pencil. Thirdly, buy a case. The case must be having a pencil holder. There are so many of them available, choose the one that fits your budget. Also, make sure that the case allows the iPad to be held in portrait or landscape mode depending upon the kind of usage you have. If you're more on consuming media, you might prefer more of landscape mode, which is available in almost all the iPad covers. But if you read a lot of books, you might need the portrait mode more, in which case you will need a rotating case that can hold the iPad vertically. Now for the final verdict. After iOS 11, iPad Pro 10.5-inch is good enough to replace the MacBook Air for a lot of people. If you use your laptop just to browse the web, watch videos, write, listen to music, and perform other basic tasks, and you do use pen and paper a lot, then the iPad Pro is an excellent gadget for you. It can do most of these things without breaking a sweat. But so could the less expensive iPad 2018. As a laptop replacement, I still wouldn't jump over it just yet, as there are no USB ports to connect peripherals like a pen drive or a hard drive. There are wireless options for pen drives and hard drives, but anything that is not physically connected is slow in data transfer. The iPad Pro is not a MacBook replacement just yet, but it's slowly getting there. Apple has built a premium tablet with an excellent display that delivers great performance in a market where there is virtually no competition. There is absolutely no doubt that the iPad Pro lineup is a big part of Apple's overall strategy. With iOS 11 release, Apple has shown how serious it is about its intention to pitch the iPad Pro models as productivity-oriented computers for professionals, not just as entertainment devices. I did compare the user experience of the Samsung Galaxy Tab S3 recently, just to be sure about the competition, but the Android tablet experience is nowhere near as polished as I've gotten used to with the Apple's iPad lineup. That means the iPad Pro has a pretty big lead against all other tablets currently on the market. Its nearest competitor would be the iPad 2018 model. It doesn't have as good a display or processor, and it also lacks the smart connector required for Apple's neat smart keyboard case, but it's a lot less expensive, and you could always use a Bluetooth keyboard instead. If the Pro's extra features don't matter to you and you want a tablet for casual use, the iPad 2018 is a good choice. But if you want to get the best device for your money, bang for the buck, and experience, then iPad Pro 2017 it is. If you have any questions, suggestions, or requests, please drop them in the comment section below. If you like this video, do not forget to hit the thumbs up button. You'll find a lot of gadget videos and software videos in this channel, so do consider subscribing. This is Kalyan Kumar signing off. Have a great day. Goodbye, and thank you for watching.